Hello, I am Rob, and this is another EUSDS online class. This one will be about putting accents and style into your dancing, and it's in two parts. So the first part is going to be simpler rhythms, and then the second part is going to be more complex rhythms, and this is part one. The video will be done in solo, and it's designed for you to be able to practice it in solo. But there is going to be a partnered aspect to it. I've enlisted Ellen, and we'll have a little section where we've got the same idea but put into a partnered move, and that will be seamlessly edited in later. I'm not a video editor, so we'll see how that one goes. But you can practice this by yourself and then incorporate it into either your solo dancing or your partnered dancing when we get out on back onto the dance floors again, which is hopefully some point sometime soon. We'll see. The concept, as I said, of the accents and style in your dancing, the idea is that you get given steps and moves and movements to do. You can choose how to do them. You can make your own decisions about how you do your dance, and certain things will work for you in some ways that you might not realise to begin with until you practice a few different ways. And if you look back at all the videos from 1930s, 40s, 50s of the dance floors then, each of the dancers had their own style. So you can develop your own style in certain ways by practicing and thinking in a particular way. Before we get started properly, I've got a few things to mention, four things to mention. Firstly, you can just watch this video, but you'll get more out of it if you try what I'm suggesting. The more you practice, the more you'll learn about yourself. The second thing, what was my second thing, is that I'm going to play music at certain points, but not for very long. So the music is the practice time for you to work on yourself. But I'm not going to play a whole song just to keep the length of the video down. But that's where you can either pause or rewind or play your own music entirely, rather than just do it for the minute or so that I'll be doing it. Do it for longer. Do for a whole full song, two or three songs, if you want to. My next thing. Oh, yeah. So if you feel like your dancing isn't what it used to be because we can't dance right now, me too. Ellen and I, we filmed the partner bit yesterday. And we both had that thought of, I know what to do. I know how to do this. Why isn't it working? It's not working as well as it used to. Perfectly natural, because we just haven't been doing it as regularly as we were before. If things feel a bit weird, yeah, that's fine. Life's kind of weird anyway. We're in a very weird situation. Just go for it. Do what you can under the circumstances. My last thing was, oh yeah, that's right. So I'm in my flat. I'm on a carpet. And my neighbours downstairs don't like it when we dance. So I'm going to be stepping very lightly, going quite softly with all of this, but you don't have to. If you're on a floor that can take it and you're not going to disturb your neighbours, and you can really ground yourself, really get some energy down into the ground and get a bit more dramatic with it than I will in this lesson, in my demonstration. So that's all my stuff. Right, let's get started then. So the idea of putting some stuff into the dancing that's your decision. The way I want to think about that today is by, you've got three modes of movement. So we've got, first one is just our casual, everyday, not really trying that hard way of doing things. You shouldn't have to think about it too much. You just do it. You use the minimum amount of effort to make it work, no more, no less, and that's it. So that's our first one. Our second one is a bit more loose. Let things kind of sink down, let things flow. Let it delay a tiny bit so it feels like it's lasting longer than maybe it is. And that's our second one. And our third one is sharp and precise. And that means toning up. You can tone up your core. This really helps. You can end up toning up your arms and your legs as well. And you kind of like make more staccato, sharper movements. And then things end a bit earlier than you might think they would. And you end up possibly holding for a second before you go into something else. So those are our three modes of moving and our ways of thinking. Easiest way to demonstrate them is, and to practice them, is just with some simple steps on the spot. We're only going to do that really quickly because it's not that interesting by itself. What all I'm going to do is put a song on, and we'll pulse to begin with, and then we'll do some steps, and then we'll try the different feels of those steps. So bear with me while I put a song on. Okay. Pulsing to begin with. And this is just our usual jazz stance, our get down, our knees are bent, our kind of backslides out, just a tiny bit maybe. Just go up and down to the music. And now we want to do some, and a step. And this should just be, again, this is our casual, basic, walking down the street. You're not having to think really about what you're doing. And I'm just clicking so you can, I can keep feeling the beat. Okay? Now, loose. You're still doing a step in every other beat. But now, things flow a bit more. And you sink down. You might find your arms. Hey. That was our loose. If we go sharp. You might notice the pulse can go away for this. You're still stepping in every other beat. And that's the idea. We've got our casual, our loose, and our sharp. And I'll pause the music. So that is, I actually think, now that I've been trying this a few times myself, I think doing that kind of thing is how the original dancers from the original generations, 30s, 40s and 50s and 20s, came up with a lot of the stuff. I found myself kind of doing this kind of thing with the loose movement. And this is, you know, you can get into this kind of thing. It kind of just, it's a thing that can naturally progress into it. With our sharper movements, I found myself doing that kind of like, my feet twisted out and I did this. And that's the kind of Applejack's movement there. Whatever you work on, you'll probably find ways to move that are new to you, which is part of what this is about. This is self-discovery more than anything else. So that was our basic kind of demonstration of the idea. I'm going to put that idea into a couple of simple jazz steps with simple rhythms, and we're going to work through it. The first one we're going to do is a box step, which is this. Hey, who, ha, ha, and a one, two, three, four, five, six, seven, and a hoop, yeah, who. Excuse me, sorry. There we go. If you watched Sarah's Tranky Do online class, this is in the Tranky Do, and you'll also see it in various other things as well. It's a nice easy bust out. I'm not sure what to do, we can do a box step. In case you haven't done it before, I will demonstrate here. And we'll go that way first. You can go either way, but we're gonna go this way to begin with. So what we wanna do is weights on this foot, on our left foot. We're gonna step our right foot across. We're then gonna go backwards. We're going to go back to where we would normally kind of feet are side by side and then step in front again. And that's the whole thing. It goes across, back, back, in front, across, back, to the side, in front. That was going that way first. You can go the other way. We've got an across, who, ha, hey, and then a who, ha. Now, we've got our, that was our casual. We can make it loose or we can make it sharp. Loose tends to be lower down. Ho. Ha, who, and then a who, ha, who, ha, and then a who, ha. And you can sort of exaggerate as well with arms going also. You've got your sharper. Who, ha, he, ha, and then a who, ha, who, ha, and a who, ha, ha, and so on. And you can mix those together as well. You can go casual to begin with and then go into loose and then sharp and then loose and sharp and so on and so on. That's that concept. We also have, if you're already comfortable with that and want to have a bit more difficult things to play around with on top of it, we do our normal box step in a half time. Ha! That means stepping on every other beat. One, two, one, two, one, two, one, two, one, two. You can step on single time as well. So we've got a slow, hey, who, ha, wha, ba, do, ba, hey. You probably won't see people doing continuous single time steps over and over and over again. Gets a bit too much. But it can be thrown in as a kind of who, ha, wah, ba, hey, who, ha. And you can use that quick, quick, the single time steps to change sides. Who, ha, hey, ha, who, ha, ha, who, ba. There it is. Sorry, I practiced this and then I forgot how it was done. Hey, who, ha, wah, ba, go, hey. Ha, and a who, ha, hey, what, that, go, ha. You can use it for that purpose. Now, music time. We've got our box step. You can go in either direction. You can be casual, loose, or sharp with it. And then you can do quicks some of the time, and you can also change direction. Let's have a go. Again, I'll play for about a minute, minute and a half. And I'll play a different song. Thank you. I'm starting out nice and casual. And I go into it a bit loose. My steps maybe get a bit bigger. And then. And I'll just let you play around with it about yourself. Hopefully you get the idea. Again, please do play a longer song in your own time to play with that a bit more. The concept itself is fairly straightforward. The thing that I find is more challenging if you haven't done it before is linking them together. If you aren't used to it, the muscle memory, you have to consciously make the thing happen. And if you're trying to do that without already being used to it, your feet stepping in certain ways and giving it a certain feel and a speed, you have lots to think about. And the only way to get better at that is just do it over and over and over again. And if you mentally get a bit lost with it, your muscles can kind of just take over. You don't have to worry about it. And that's one of the really fun things about doing lots of solo jazz and partnered stuff as well, is it becomes more easy to improvise because you don't have to consciously think about every little thing. And at this point now, if you joined in with that, you were then improvising your solo jazz. If you had never done that before, it's easier than it seems once you've got a few things to play with. And if you come at the stance from a partner perspective first, which is what I did and still that is my preference, you learn the partnered stuff, you learn the partner interactions and how you move in the step. And then when you do it by yourself, you don't have that other person to kind of bounce off. And then you're like, oh crap, what do I do? And this is one thing you can do. Pick a simple step, two or three, link them together, and make them yours. So that was our second thing. I'll just make sure I haven't forgotten anything. No, that was it. All right, so we're on to our final solo step for this. I don't know the name of this. I'm sure there is one. I'm sure I've seen it and heard it said, and I can't remember. It's just doing this. Step and a hey, and then a step, and then a hey. And from another direction it goes step, hey, and a step, hey. I watched back Sarah's Mama Stew video. It's a good little range of videos on the AUSDS channel. If you haven't seen them, go back and watch a few of them. There's some nice solo and partner stuff in there. So yeah, the Mama Stew, Sarah did it as Hallelujahs, which is like a lunge forward and dramatically throw your arms up, and then a hey, and then a hey. It's that same thing if you did that video, if you've done that routine, but it's, we're doing it a much more chilled out way to begin with, just like this. Hey, that's our basic. I'm stepping onto my right foot. I don't think it matters too much which way you go, but I'm going to go with my right, and then a right, and then let's say it counts. We can make that loose as well. So we've got a hey, ha, and then a hey, ha. Or we can make it sharp, hoop, ha, and then a hoop, ha. You've got those three options, as always. Now, in terms of social dancing this, doing that one thing over and over and over again and again can be tedious and also quite dizzying. Probably both. So what we're actually going to do when we social dance that, I'm going to put the song on in a second, is our bass step isn't going to be that. Our bass step is going to be a 1920s Charleston like this. Just like a very simple version of it. And we're going to start off with that. And then when you want to, we're going to do this step, turn, step, turn. That 20 Charleston, Jamie did a video on it. I think it was like last Monday, I think. Yeah, a lot of good stuff. I will very, very, very quickly just run through it again. If you haven't ever done this before, we're going to do a little tap forward first. We're going to wait on our left foot. We're going to tap forward with our right, and then we're going to step back onto it. We're going to tap backwards with our left, and then step, and then a tap, and then a step, and then a tap, and then a step, and then a tap, and then a step. For those already proficient, you can do your twisty feet. If you haven't done that before, now's not the time. Work on it at a separate point. Maybe watch Jamie's video back. So, we're going to start off with this song doing our 20s Charleston. Who? Hey, and then a who? Hey, nice and casual. That also can be ha, who, and of course. And then put this in ha, who, ha. Make it casual, loose, or sharp. Charleston does feel very strange at this speed, but we're sticking with it. It can just be the attack. And when you're ready, hey. And you might find then these little kind of things come out. When I try and do a sharp one, it's kind of like a hoop. I do a loose. Hey. Hey. And I'll just let you do a couple more. I'll do some myself, but I'll let you choose what you do yourself. As you can see, you can put in the casual, loose and sharp in that, and it starts to bring out different things in your movement as well. So you've then got other things you can do in this as well, and one of the reasons I like this such simple movement is you can accent it in other ways. And a couple of them sort of came out while I was doing this. One of them is, and I'm going to go this way with it, is that back leg go out. Rather than just a step, who, step, relax, hey, I'm going step, hey, step. Hey, the way I'm kind of making this happen, I'm sort of making my leg straight and putting it out, and you might also see this little twist. And doing this sends my hips so that my leg goes off in that direction. Say the direction, depending on which way you're going. So if I then do this, hey, hey, it puts that little accent on. In that little where there's a gap, and it's on the four when this happens. One, oh, it's on the two, sorry. And a one, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. On that two, it's always on an even count when we're doing this kind of thing. You've got other stuff you can do in that time as well. So there's a hey, hey, hey. You can just kind of bring that leg in as well. Hey, hey, hitch, ha. Those options there. If you want to bring more arms into it, hey, hey. And again, this can be sharp or loose. Hey, hey, or hey, hey. I've got that option. There's a click as well. I find myself often when I'm doing this. Hey, I think that's a really common way of doing it. And there's just something about hitting that. Hey, is really nice. You've also got a clap. Who clap, hey, who clap, hey. Was there anything else I wanted to throw in for that one before we practice it? No, that was all of the stuff for this go. So again, I'll put the song on for about a minute, maybe not as long this time. And again, I'm just gonna do a few of these back and forth. You've got your style in terms of how loose and sharp it is, and then extra stuff, extra accents that you want to put in as well. I'm gonna keep that song going. Thank you. whatever, it's fine. And that last little bit thing that I did just there is the last thing we're going to do in this video, in the solo section, which is just this. And it's often done as a sharp movement, a kind of like a in, out. Bring the feet in, shoot them out, in, out. And it can go into a lot of different places. If you watched Laura and Yussi's Swing Out Footwork Variations video, again, good little range of stuff that's been put up so far. They do this in part of the swing out. There's a bit of like a in, out, hold, and then they come in together. Use that same idea here, but we're gonna go sharper. I think they did an in and out, whereas we're gonna go in, out. But you've got both options. And this can go in, like I said, lots of different places. What we're gonna do is put it in the 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and a 1, and a 3, and a 5, and a 7. 1, 3, 5, 6, 7, and a 1, 3, 5, 7. It's gonna come on the 5, 6 for us, which means we hit on that 6. There's a beat or two of just holding the 6 and the 7, we stay still. And then we start moving on the 8, ready to do our little tap on the 1. I'll just do it a few times. I'll do, I'll go in this direction, so I think you'll be able to see it more easily. We'll do a basic Charleston, and then that with the hit on the 5-6, and then a basic Charleston, and that again. And I'll put a song on and have a few goes. I'm going to up it a tiny bit, speed-wise. I talked about hitting on the 5 and the 6. That can hit on the 6, 7 instead. I'll demonstrate it. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and a 1, 2, 3, 4. That's it. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and a 1. Just doing it a beat later, I'll do one more. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and a 1, 3. Just doing it a little bit later gives it a different feel. You can play around with both. Again, do please put on some music in your own time and try all these things. I think that was everything I was going to do in the solo. I'm just going to check. Yes, it is. So I'll really quickly recap it. So we've got our casual, middle of the road way of doing things. We've got a really loose. We've got a sharp. Ha, we did our box steps. Loose, sharp, and we can then change direction with them with a whoop, da, and a go. Ha. And then we've got our this thing. Ha, hoo, ha, hey. With accents. Ha, hey, hoo, ha, hey. And so on. And then we've got our 1, 3, hoo, ha. Now, I am in a second going to cut to the partnered thing that Ellen and I did together. It's a very similar thing to this, but led in a partnered and led and followed way. I would, on the leader's side, do a rock step, slow, slow, ha. And just make sure that I turn around quick enough within the 8 counts to point to Ellen. Following it, you just go 1, 2, 3, 5, 7, 8, and be ready to go again. It's led and followed, very light touch. There's not a huge amount of this has to happen in a certain way going on. It's more of a general, we'll just do a turn. Let's just assume it's going to be 8 counts, and you kind of just go with it and end up at that point. But you can then put in these accents, these legs, arms, and then hoo, ha, which I think we actually forgot to film that bit, but you can throw that in on the 5-6 or the 6-7 and still be there. I think, yes. So, I'll cut to that in a second, but before I do that, thank you for watching this video. Thank you for watching all the USDS videos. It's nice to see that people are still engaging with it when we can't actually dance at the moment. At some point soon, I hope we will. I am looking forward to dancing with you all again. If this particular way of doing things was useful, I hope it was, I hope you found something interesting to work on. If you found that it was good and you want more, either let me or EUSDS know. I am happy to do more of this style of thing, picking something to work on and then putting it into a few different places. Again, all of this stuff, you work on it in solo and it means your partner dancing will be better and it means your solo just gets more fun as well. So thank you very much for watching, and I will then hand over to the partnered section. Thank you. All right, Ellen's here.
Ta-da.
Yeah. We're going to take that basic idea of putting some accents and style into your solo dancing and show how that can fit into your partner dancing as well. Not meant to have a partner right now because of lockdown, but when
unless
we get
you're
to,
lucky.
Yeah. When we get to do that again, this is the kind of thing you can do. We've got this move. Show it again. And so on. So, as far as we're aware, there's not a name for that. It's not a move as such. And it's different to where we might have a swing out or a tuck turn or something that's got momentum and flow and continuation. This is different in that smaller in terms of led and followed. And I'm kind of just inviting Ella, hey, how about we do this fun turn? Our rock steps are going to be smaller. I'm going to try and lead them smaller. And that turn is kind of, I've set it up, but then I'm kind of letting Ellen interpret how she wants.
Yeah, it's just because Rob's turning that I end up turning, it makes sense for me to continue turning outwards and then meet back up with him at the end.
So we'll show it again. And you could even, I would probably interact quite a lot more with this than I would maybe with a swing out, with the kind of look towards. Hey! Do that, and so on. So that's our basic version. There's a quick, quick, slow, slow, quick, quick to get back around within eight counts, which we're kind of just using as a, it's easy to fit something into eight counts. So we'll just go for that and it can be changed if you choose. We can put some styling into that. So we did a kind of really chilled out stepping and hanging out and stepping around. You can put even just a kick in maybe.
Boop, ha,
hey.
Ha.
So we'll do a chilled out one. A boop. Hey. Do a swing out. And there. Hey. And so on. So you can put that something slightly more stylistic in there. You've also got a knee slap.
Mm-hmm.
Hey. Also a clap. Hey. And you'll sort of see that. That four is when the clap or the knee slap happens, the accent, and there's a bit of a gap there, so that's what we're going to fill with that thing. You've then got, you can change the rhythm a bit, you can elongate it out by going, boop, boop, hold, and I fell off because we bounced against each other. Try that again, boop, hold, and triple, and a hey. And it's just a, you've got that time to play around with it yourself a tiny bit, and you can do different things. But it's still, the idea is we're just going to kind of come in, turn out, and end up back facing each other in open.
And that's not physically led or followed. So in that way, I was doing it the normal way, you were doing it the slow way. But if I notice that Rob is like visually Ooh. Slowing down.
Hey, triple and a hey.
I can decide to slow down with him.
Yeah. Cool. Thank you.